Welcome to Imperva. I'm Jim Bertoff, security engineer here at Imperva, and today I'm in my hotel room here in Arlington because that's where the Distill offices are. And we're going to be talking today about installing the Distill bot connector for the Amazon Lambda environment.
Installing this connector is a multi-step process, and you may not need to do all of these steps depending on what your environment is. So the first thing we need to do is compile a custom connector with your settings inside of it. If you've been given a zip by a teacher or support, then you may not have to do this. And you can do this on any environment. We're going to do it on an Amazon Linux environment. We need to go into Amazon and create the Lambda function, and we're going to add that zip to it. We need to create the CloudFront distribution point if you don't have that already created. And then we need to edit the CloudFront distribution point to add that Lambda function in that we created to make sure that it gets executed every time someone makes a call. So these are the different sections. You can skip around if you've already got some of those done, or you can watch through as needed. And we start with how to compile the connector. So to get started, we need to get a copy of the code for the connector. And to do that, we're going to go to docs.distillconnector.com. And we're going to go down here to section 7. Since we're doing the AWS CloudFront Lambda, we're going to grab this link right here. And in this case, I'm going to right-click copy link address because I'm going to use that in a minute. So now we're going to access a Linux system, whether it is an Amazon Linux instance like I'm accessing here, or if you have another box or maybe your desktop, or if you're using a Mac. Either way, that's fine. We're going to wget the link that we just copied, and then we're going to go through the Node.js installation process. If you already have a system or somebody else already has an environment that they can build this, that's great. You can skip ahead a few steps, but we're going to take you through the process to install Node.js, compile the zip with your config file, and then upload that to the Lambda instance. The next thing that we are going to want to do is install Node.js on our Amazon Linux EC2 or wherever you happen to be. Since I'm on Amazon Linux, I'm following those instructions. So we're going to grab the install script. We're going to run it. Then we're going to initiate the NVM so that we can download and install Node. Now we're grabbing the latest version. The runtime that we're going to use later on in the Lambda environment, we recommend to be 10. At this point, I'm using the latest version. If you have problems, you can always try going to 10, but the latest version should work just for the compilation, because again, we're not doing anything crazy here. And again, at this process, we are just getting Node.js installed, and then we're going to run a quick command to make sure that we have it installed and running correctly. Once we make sure that works, we need to log into the Distill Networks portal. Make sure you're on the Connector tab. Go into a site that you set up, and you're going to need this configuration information for your config file. Now, back to your Linux environment, we're going to want to unzip the file that we downloaded originally with the wget, and we're going to cd into the source directory so that we can edit the config.js file with the information that we got from the portal. Again, whether it was from the Distill portal or the Imperva account information site, wherever you got that, we're going to be copying that in. So you can see we've got these lines at the beginning of the config.js file that are the same as the ones that we're going to copy from the portal. And so we're going to delete the ones that are in there and then copy and paste. Be careful if you're copying, you might pick up two extra brackets, and so then you got to go back and delete those. Make sure you're not in insert mode when you click DD. And then save it, and then go back and edit it again because you forgot the comma at the end. Then go ahead and save it again. All right, since I didn't mention it before, we are following the instructions available in the readme.md, which is part of the zip. So you can see we've already edited the source config.js. We're going to run the npm install and then the npm run build package. I do this from the distill lambda directory, not from inside the source directory. I don't know if it makes a difference, but the goal is to end up with the zip at the end that has your customized config file in it. If you were able to do this successfully, you should end up with the lambda function.zip in the directory that you did the build package from. So you have your zip file, whether you created it or were given it. Now we need to create a lambda function to put that code into. So at this point, we just finished creating the distill zip with our specific configuration in it. Now we need to go into our AWS console and create a lambda function that we can deploy that zip in. Make sure you do it in the US East North Virginia, at least of early 2020. That's where the at edge functionality was. It wasn't necessarily available everywhere else. Give your function a name. Make sure that you choose the runtime of Node.js.10. Again, this is as of early 2020. You'll need to create a role, give it a name, and create it from an existing AWS policy template. We'll want to use the one with the at edge permissions. And then go ahead and create the function. Let that run for a little bit. While that is creating, I will just grab a copy of the zip file from my Amazon Linux installation. Of course, if you did this on a Mac or Linux, you have this locally. Once your Lambda function is done creating, you now need to give it the code to run. So we're going to upload from a zip file. Go ahead and pick that zip file that we grabbed before that you had locally, and then save it. And you should see something like this. If you prefer to do the last step through the command line instead of the browser, you can type AWS Lambda list functions to make sure that you have your AWS command, and that's functions with an S at the end, to make sure you have your AWS command line working, and then you can type this command to add it, the zip file directly from the Linux workstation. Whether you updated it through the command line or through the GUI, we now need to make that available, so go ahead and publish your Lambda function. And while you're here, go ahead and copy that ARN for this distill function. We're going to need it later. You may need a colon version number at the end of that. Since we're doing this through CloudFront, we now need a CloudFront distribution point. You may already have this created, and if you do, that's great. If not, here's how you create one. Now, if you don't already have your site being distributed by CloudFront, you'll need to set that up. So go to the CloudFront section. We're going to create a new distribution point for the web. Give it the original domain name. In my case, it's an EC2 instance. And go ahead and just fill out the rest of those. I think the defaults were fine for me, except for the port that I was using. I had it running on 8080. But everything else, if you're just setting this up for the test, should be fine with the defaults. Now, it can take a little while to process. You know that it's done successfully when you copy that domain name that you've been assigned by CloudFront, and you're able to go into the browser and get to your website. If you can't get past this point, then go back and fix something. Now that we've compiled our connector, we've created the Lambda function, added the connector to it, created the CloudFront distribution point. We now need to edit that CloudFront distribution behavior so that it will call that Lambda function as needed. Now that you got things working through CloudFront, or maybe you already had it set up, we're going to tie it all together. So you go back to CloudFront, you go to the distribution that you set up, and go to the Behaviors tab. Now we're going to, you can either edit the default, create a new one. We're going to select the CloudFront event of origin request. We're going to put in that Lambda function ARN with a version number at the end. Include the body, and then go back through and make a few other setting changes. Again, these are all defined in the readme.md. If you take a look at that, there may be some of these that you need to have a different setting for, or maybe some that you don't need to have set at all. Just go through, take a look at those. And then when we're done, we're going to save it. And we should be good for the Amazon section. Now, there's still a whole other section that you need to do on the website itself to make sure that we are downloading the JavaScript and calling it. However, embedding the tag is specific to your site, so we're not going to cover that in the video. So make sure you save it, and you should be good to go. Just a quick note from the team as far as the CloudFront settings, in case you missed what we did in the video, or in case I did anything wrong, if there's any questions or conflicts, the README is the right one.
So that's how you get the pod connector downloaded, compiled with your information, and installed out to a Lambda CloudFront environment. The next videos will go over the changes that you need to make to your website to take advantage of that. Thanks a lot.